And so this is the view of the control room, and this is the first transparency or the first photo that was taken when the beam went right the way around and came back on the same spot. And that's why you see the two spots. And there was great excitement in the control rooms of the machine and the experiments, which you can visibly see from the faces of the people. And this is one of the pictures that was taken in the CMS. So it's a display of an event that took place. Now, all the indications from this work are that these complex instruments that make up the accelerated experiments can indeed work very well, according to specifications, in fact. Unfortunately, there was an incident on the 19th of September last year during the commissioning of the last main bend, which is actually the last few days of a year-long process, where something went wrong. And there was an incident which resulted in large discharge of helium into the tunnel and created a fair amount of collateral mechanical damage, which is now being repaired. And the most sensitive diagnostic instrumentation is being installed, and we should be coming back online in September, October this year. Now, when we restart, what we'll do first is to verify the detectors are indeed performing well. We think they are. We know that they are. We have to check it again. And then we have to verify that we find exactly what is predicted for known physics. Now, I'll show you some peaks there. These are particles which were discovered in earlier times. In fact, the particle in the middle, actually, the person who discovered it sitting in the audience here, all of these particles merited a Nobel Prize. And we clearly are checking these. These have become standard candles, as we say. And we look for new physics. So what can new physics be? It could be particles of which could be explained dark matter. There's a symmetry called supersymmetry, which actually doubles up the spectrum of particles. For every particle, we have a superparticle. Electron, we have a superelectron. So you might actually be in a position to make these discoveries if you work in particle physics in the next 5-10 years. And then on the right-hand side is what the Higgs boson might look like. This is a peak, and I won't have time to explain exactly what is shown there. On the left-hand side, what you can see is that there's particles on one side, there's nothing on the other side. And that is a possible candidate for the dark matter particle, which is what we call a weakly interacting massive particle. And that's the next plot. I just wanted to wrap up and say a few words about cosmology as well, in a sense. Now, here is a composite picture taken using images from Magellan, from Hubble. So these are optical images. You can see the stars there. You can see Chandra, which is actually looking at hot gas, which is shown in red. And this is a collision of two clusters of galaxies zooming in very fast. And blue is data taken from gravitational lenses. If you have a very large mass and you're looking at something far away, light can bend this way, and you appear to see two objects when there is only one object. And from there, you can deduce the mass of the object, which actually is dark matter. It's not scintillating. It's not like stars. It doesn't emit light as such. And from there, you can see in the collision, the gas has clumped together, but the dark matter has gone right the way through. Very indicative of the type of particle which I was showing you in the previous transparency. So this could be one of the things that could be discovered in the LHC, and this will be a very radical and important discovery if you make that one. So let me conclude. So the project was conceived and designed to attack fundamental questions in particle physics, and the accelerator and the experiments are unprecedented in complexity. I've tried to give you some idea of that. And they will operate in an unprecedented environment. 1 billion pairs of protons interact every second that lead to huge radiation levels as well, which have to be, so the objects that we have there, the detectors have to survive that. The accelerated experiments have required a long and painstaking effort on a global scale. This is actually driven by science at the frontier of knowledge. And many technologies have been pushed to their limits. Some have been invented. They didn't exist 20 years ago. And they're unique and unparalleled scientific instruments, and we expect collisions in October or last quarter of this year. Now, I just wanted to say a few more words. It's only experiments that reveal or confirm nature's inner secrets. And the expectations that we have are that what we will find at the LHC will reform our understanding of nature at the most fundamental level. And the last transparency I just wanted to show, it's an epilogue. I started with Newton, with his theory of gravitation, and I'll end with some quotes from it. One, which is a sense of privilege in actually doing the science that we're doing. And the second one is humility. The first one says, to me, there has never been a higher source of earthly honor or distinction than that connected with advances in science. And we believe we shall be making advances in science. And the second one is, I seem to have been only like a boy playing on the seashore and diverting myself in now and then finding a smoother pebble or a prettier shell than ordinary, whilst the great ocean of truth lay all and undiscovered before me. And that's essentially a call for you guys to go look for the undiscovered things. And thank you.